Liverpool is always moving forward. It's in our DNA. The last decade has seen the city deliver some of the most ambitious development projects anywhere in Europe. Our ambition has transformed the city's skyline and reaffirmed Liverpool's position as a world-class city with a world-class vision. The journey continues. In the next 15 years, we will embark on a bold new plan, the Liverpool City Centre Strategic Investment Framework. We know that it's the people who live, work, invest, study, and enjoy our city that makes us what we are. That makes us Liverpool.
I see so many business community, so much of the business community represented in a meeting held by a politician and chaired by Chief Executive Vision. I thought it was the hopes for the city are clearly deeply felt by a large number of people. As encouraged by the comments from overseas. Filling in the gaps and creating jobs is a key opportunity which mustn't be missed for the city. And the support of Joe, Max and his team is key to that.
I think what's important about this plan is essentially it's a job creation plan. Now it may look like a plan that's trying to improve the great streets or the great squares, but really what we're saying is that's just a means to an end. We all want to live in a beautiful city, but what's most important is if you create a beautiful city, if you create a city that's got a quality of life, then what you're doing is actually creating the place that knowledge workers, who basically live anywhere, will want to live.
I like the idea that it's a series of projects, and I like the idea of one of the main themes is connectivity. I think one of the big things about Liverpool is that we've got to join it all together, we've got to embrace the different zones and neighbourhoods, and I think that's exactly what it proposes.
In the circumstances we're in the moment with limited funding availability, it's actually good to look at the gaps between the buildings and actually the spaces between the buildings and make the city feel like a better place from that point of view.
I listened to what was said today, very impressed by it, very mature, very grown up. Building upon what we've done already, not protesting too much, really impressed, nice analysis, good commitment. Mayor did a very nice explanation and commitment. I think it's a good news story, basically, so I was very happy with it.
What Liverpool is doing is very much in tune with what central government is wanting to do. And what I've seen here this morning is absolutely a marvellous plan for carrying on for what Liverpool has already achieved in its infrastructure. Now it is building on that.
Innovative thinking will re-energise our thriving commercial district. New development opportunities will see the area grow and provide connections with the ambitious Liverpool Waters project. The Strand will realise its true potential as one of Europe's most iconic city centre boulevards, with a series of major new pedestrian links, green edges and open spaces. Our vision understands a simple truth. A city isn't just about projects, it's about people. £1 billion leisure and retail centres can only work when the city wraps its arms around them, welcomes them, makes them feel at home. We're good at that in Liverpool. That's why we're in the top three of the UK's most visited cities. Our ambition is to make Liverpool one of the world's best cities to live, work, invest, study, and visit. For now, our tour ends here at the spirit of the city, the iconic waterfront. It's Liverpool.